It is day one of the 10 days of prayer, and we greet you today and ask that you join us as we meditate on these words. Why don't we begin with prayer? Father, please help us to be blessed by that which we will read, hear, and understand. In your name we pray. Amen. Day one, the topic is Jesus' most precious gift. And the scripture passage for meditation is Luke chapter 11, verse 13. This is what the Bible says. How much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? I have nothing. Lord, teach us how to pray, the disciples pleaded. They saw how Jesus connected daily with his heavenly Father and longed for the same power in their own lives. Jesus responded with a memorable prayer lesson in three parts: the Lord's Prayer, the parable of a friend coming at midnight, and in climax, the need to continually request the Holy Spirit. In the parable, verses 5 to 8, a man has nothing to feed a visitor who arrives late in the evening. The man hurries to his neighbor and asks for bread to feed the visitor, explaining, "I have nothing." He continues asking until at last he receives bread to share with his guest. In this story, we see that we have to come to Jesus in order to have something to share with others. When we want to pass on the bread of life, we often realize that we have nothing to give. Then Jesus links the parable, or the problem in this parable, "I have nothing," with our need to request the Holy Spirit. "So I say to you, ask, and it will be given you." Here in Luke chapter 11, Jesus emphasizes 10 times that we should ask for the Holy Spirit in our lives. I know of no other passage where he so lovingly urges us to take something to heart. "So I say to you, ask, and it shall be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds. And to him who knocks, it will be opened. If a son asks for bread from any father among him, will he give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will he give him a serpent instead of a fish? Or if he asks for an egg, will he offer him a scorpion? If you then," this is Luke 11, 9 to 13, "if you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" In these few verses, Jesus uses the verb ask 6 times and emphasizes the idea with seek 2 times and knock 2 times. These are all action verbs. He clearly shows that we must take action in order to be filled with the Holy Spirit. The last use of ask in the Greek is in the continuous tense, which means that we should ask not just once, but keep asking. Clearly, Jesus wants to awaken our desire for the Holy Spirit with this heartfelt invitation. He knows we're missing something crucial if we don't actually ask for the rich blessings of the Holy Spirit. In Christ's object lesson, we read, God does not say, "Ask once and you shall receive." He bids us ask. Unwearingly persist in prayer. Persistent asking brings the petitioner into a more earnest attitude and gives him an increased desire to receive the things for which he asks. And consider for a moment, why did Jesus himself spend so much time in daily prayer? Ellen White explains, "Morning by morning, he communicated with his Father in heaven, receiving from him daily a fresh baptism of the Holy Ghost. Indeed, as I close, Jesus was our example. Ask yourself, if Jesus needed a daily refreshing from the Holy Spirit, then how much more is it important? I pray that the Lord will bless you. And even as you think you have nothing, may you recognize that with Christ, you have everything.
Dear God, Father, we come to you thanking you, dear Lord, for your goodness and your grace. We thank you, dear Lord, for being a great God. We thank you, dear Lord, for dying on the cross for our sins. And we're asking you, dear Jesus, that you won't just be with us, dear Father. Lord, you know the things that we need more than we do. And I'm asking you, dear Father, that you will send your Holy Spirit in his fullness in our lives. We know, Lord, to get the work done, we need the Holy Spirit. There's nothing we can do, Father, unless we have the Holy Spirit in our hearts and our minds. So I'm asking you, dear Father, if you could do that. Our country needs you right now, Lord. Your church needs you right now. And the only way, Father, to be ready is if you direct your Holy Spirit into our lives. Father, thank you so much for being here with us. Thank you for the readings, dear Lord, that we've been doing. And I'm asking you, dear Father, that you will help us, Lord, to put into practice what we read each day. Help us to spend more time in your word. Help us, dear Lord, to be directed in every aspect of our life, Lord, knowing that your coming is very soon. So, Lord, thank you once again, and we claim, dear Father, your Holy Spirit in his fullness, in our hearts and our minds, in Jesus' precious name.